At the dawn of the 12th century, Basavanna, a statesman and a philosopher, championed the cause of equality and propagated the concept of worshipping Shiva in the form of Ishtalinga. He taught the world that work is worship. The followers of this tradition are today identified as Sharanas, Lingayats, or Veera Shaivas. Though there are about 99 subsects in this religion, 80% of the Lingayats belong to the Panchamasali subsect, who are a native Kannada-speaking community of people dependent on agriculture. The Panchamasali community firmly believes in the accommodative and inclusive concept of Iva Nammava, which essentially means he is ours, irrespective of one's caste, creed or religion. Currently, the population of the Panchamasali community is estimated to be around 1.5 crores, with about 85 lakh in Karnataka alone, about 40 lakh in Maharashtra and approximately 25 lakh in Telangana, Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu combined together. Panchamasalis are indeed a force to reckon in a democracy like India. The Panchamasali community has produced hundreds of great leaders. The earliest known poetess and saint, Akka Mahadevi, Keladi Rani Chennamma of the 16th century, who fearlessly fought the Mughal armies of Aurangzeb, Rani Belavadi Mallamma of the 17th century, who built an entire army of women to ward off enemies of her state, Kitturu Rani Chennamma, who clashed with the mighty British Empire even before the First War of Indian Independence of 1857. Indian revolutionary and Haveri, Karnataka's freedom fighter Mailara Mahadevappa, who played an important part in the Dandi March, organized by Mahatma Gandhi in the year 1930, and Sir Siddappa Kambli, who served as the education and agricultural minister of the erstwhile British Bombay Legislative Council, who brought great educational and agricultural reforms in the 1930s, have brought great glory to the Panchamasali community and have won many laurels for their contribution to the people of this country. The Panchamasali community has provided two chief ministers to Karnataka, S. Nijalingappa and J. H. Patil. Despite being an impressive majority in Karnataka's population, the Panchamasali community has received no special attention and has remained economically poor and socially downtrodden. The Panchamasali Samaj is represented by two Jagadguru Pithas in Karnataka, which work tirelessly for the welfare of their community. One is the Harihara Panchamasali Jagadguru Pitha and the other Koodala Sangama Panchamasali Jagadguru Pitha. After the sad demise of His Holiness Jagadguru Sri Mahanta Shivacharya Swamiji of the Harihara Panchamasali Jagadguru Pitha, the Panchamasali Sangha recognized the charisma of a young, dynamic and internationally acclaimed yoga and wellness master, Sri Vachanananda Swamiji, popularly known as Shwasaguru, as the successor of Jagadguru. He was eventually anointed as the Jagadguru of the Harihara Panchamasali Jagadguru Pitha. Being a well-read, well-traveled spiritual guru, Jagadguru Sri Vachanananda Swamiji's repute and his vision of welfare of the Panchamasalis has influenced a fresh breath of dynamism. The Koodala Sangama Panchamasali Jagadguru Pitha is headed by another young and knowledgeable Jagadguru, Jaya Mrityunjaya Swamiji, whose anointment has brought great weightage to the Panchamasali community. Lack of political representation and socio-economic misidentification has deprived the Panchamasalis of economic, educational, and institutional reservations they rightfully deserve. This issue was first raised by Sri B. M. Hanumanal, a teacher by profession, in the year 1994. He believed that the identification of the Panchamasalis in the 3B category does not really do justice to the plight they have been suffering. Hence, in the year 2003, a delegation of 80 members of the Panchamasali Sangha met the then Prime Minister Sri Atal Bihari Vajpayee in this regard. They highlighted the problems of Panchamasali community and sought for the development of the Panchamasalis through the provision of sound education and employment opportunities. Presently, under the able leadership of Jagadguru Vachanananda Swamiji of Harihara Jagadguru Pitha and Jagadguru Jaya Mrityunjaya Swamiji, the Panchamasali Samaj has been fighting injustice meted out to Panchamasalis through the denial of various benefits from the government. Panchamasalis have now realized that they have to unify and mandate the cause of their own welfare. Their calls of awareness and consolidation have begun resonating loudly amongst the political circles. People in power have now comprehended that the demand for more political representations for Panchamasalis is completely justified. Currently, through the Harihara Panchamasali Jagadguru Pitha and the Kudala Sangama Panchamasali Jagadguru Pitha, Panchamasalis stand more united than ever to safeguard their interests.